name's Cameron, and I'm here with my assistants. I'm talking about how to win friends and influence people, part 3, chapter 2. Now, I read a bit about it in the last video in part 2. I think you might have watched it, because, come on, no one skips to part 3 if you didn't watch the first part yet. No one does that. It's like watching episode of some job and you watch the last video. It's like, what the heck? Now, what also, I give you a bit on what I think it's about, but this, now I actually read it. Not the entire chapter, because 2 chapters is literally half of the book. And you think it's kind of thick, but it's half of it. That's 2 chapters. Look how long that is. This is 1 chapter. What? Yeah, I'm gonna go find where I left off right here. And right here, the chapter. I'm sure what it's called. So, fresh in mind. Oh, yeah, sure, I'm gonna get inside of it. Alright, getting out. Alright, so, in the last chapter, I told you guys about how to make friends. And this chapter is how to avoid enemies. Now, one way to make enemies is that, I'll tell you first. The way the human is that, you know how they're always greedy and stuff? They always want revenge, too. Like, someone punches you in the face, you're lit up with anger, and all you want to do is just beat them up. That's all you really want to do. When someone does a dumb act, like something really dumb that you know is wrong, such as, when a baby's solving 1 plus 1 and he says 48, you're like, like that. And, well, first of all, one way to anger a person is to show and pretend that you're better than him. It's like, you don't want to show that you're better than someone. I don't get jealous. No revenge. I mean, I did a speech a while back on, like, when my brother, he used to be number 1, and he was the best, until the day he'll never forget, I came in, I was born, and the only thing he wanted was revenge. We used to be friends, and now he's a foe. Ever since, he's been running me over. So, see, that's one way I met an enemy. I mean, I'm sure he cooled off by now. Ooh, come out of nowhere. Luckily, he's gone, he's camping, struck in the forest. But yeah, but now back to the topic. How to win friends and influence people right here. When you try to make an enemy, you could anger them by comparing them to somebody else that is really good. So I found a sentence in here which perfectly describes that. So if you go back here, alright, it says, never begin by announcing, I'm going to prove so-and-so to you. That's taunting and bad. It's just like saying right here, I'm smarter than you. I'm going to tell you a thing or two that will make you change your mind. But, I mean, alright, this is also part of influence people. I didn't tell you about that. So you're trying to influence someone to take your side on the type of argument. And then you say that. You're going to say, I'm smarter than you. I'm smarter than you are. And I'm going to tell you a thing or two that will make you change your mind. That's arguing. Don't act like you're better than him. You're just going to piss him off and he's going to go on a rampage. I mean, I'm sure everyone here has gotten angry once. It felt like they wanted to get so mad. Either it was when, I don't know when. I mean, it just happens. I forgot what happened. I don't know when, I'm sure you got angry and very mad once. Like, very, very mad. My brother gets really mad. Half the time from me. I'm sure all you watchers have been. By a brother, a sister, or a friend, or an enemy in your life, or something. And then, once you taunt them, that's just enough to break your friendship. Snap in half. It's basically, you get... The rope is holding you together. And when you taunt someone, you create a scissor. Snap. And your friendship is out. And Cindy's talking to someone. Don't you even want to be your friend anymore? It's like your best friend. The day before, it's like, come on, let's go play basketball together. Next day, hey, fatty. You look so ugly after all. You need, go to the gym, pig. That's just enough to break your guys' friendship. You don't have to hang out with that. I don't think anyone wants to. And not only does it snap up your relationship, it makes you enemies, which takes it even further. Once you guys are enemies, it's going to be really hard to be friends again. It's easier to lose friendship than to turn an enemy into a friend. When you turn an enemy into a friend, that's more of the movies and stuff. When you see gigantic Godzilla becoming good and stuff, that doesn't always happen. You expect a lion to come out of nowhere, it kills a bunch of people, and then it fusses up and joins your side. No. Now, hey, you gotta stay in line? He's a tiger. Don't get offended. We're enemies now. Yeah. I think he's not my enemy. I just taunted him with a lion because tigers hate lions. So now that we're not friends anymore, I have to toss him and dump him. He sure is really mad now. But also, I think I already told you this, but if you weren't here for a second video, then I told you that I used to be best friends with a kid when I was in second grade. And when I hung out with him, he was my first friend, first of all. He took me everywhere and stuff until he started cheating. We used to play soccer at that time. He began cheating. He began getting mad and he got more jerkyish. And he started being more of a jack. And just keeps on backstabbing people. And I don't like backstabbers. It's like the first day you're nice. It's like this. You're trusting somebody to hold on to a $1 million check. And later, since he's been your best friend for 5 years, you trust him. And later he says bye, he slams the door in your face, packs up his suitcase, and flies to Mexico with the $1 million. That's a backstabber big time. You got a concussion, which will cost a medical bill, plus you lost your $1 million. Who would want that? And, alright. This basically, but if you want to avoid that, avoid taunting, avoid fights, and avoid arguments, which is the most common way you break up relationship or friendship. Because if someone gets, all right, let's say a guy gets a girlfriend, then he does not do anything for her. And then the girlfriends are like, hey, what am I doing with you pigs? And he leaves. That's more revenge, first of all. And that's when we had gone back, but it's not necessarily a bad thing. You kind of deserved it. You're taking advantage of a woman and you're making her pay for you. And if you want to avoid snapping a relationship like I did, then avoid arguments. That's the most common way. Because if you get in an argument, you probably, 50% of the time, you're never going to get over it. And 50% of the time, you will get over it. And we said, or when you're playing a game, do not cheat, which is one way to get someone mad. Because he thinks that if he's, so the person that we do when we play soccer, he thinks that if we kick the goal like this, like kick, multiple times, he's going to get a bunch of scores. I mean, it doesn't work that way. It restarts after one ball. It's like, what? And that's basically... Guys, all mad. And then later... Why? Really mad. And then later, we didn't want to be friends with him. Now, you guys could avoid that situation by not acting like me at the time because I didn't know better in second grade. And instead, you should have changed the subject, which I talked about yesterday. Which is part two, yesterday. Yeah. And then, I mean, I kind of catch up on my videos. I mean, lately we've been doing traveling and not any book reviews. That's why we're now starting to do more and more. Because we're on a 2-3 streak right now. But also, wait, am I holding it backwards? Oh, yeah. And when you change the subject, they're not going to think about it anymore. First of all, you're talking about elephants, and now you're talking about tigers.
Did you say something?
No, I didn't, tiger. Well, now, that's all for this time. And I hope you guys enjoyed. Bye for now.